Christ, having risen from the dead, dies now no more. Death will no longer have dominion over him. Alleluia. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you raise us new life. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and your blood. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that we who have been renewed by paschal remedies, transcending the likeness of our earthly parentage, may be transformed in the image of our heavenly Maker, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. After their release, Peter and John went back to their own people and reported what the chief priests and elders had told them. And when they heard it, they raised their voices to God with one accord and said, Sovereign Lord, maker of heaven and earth, and the sea and all that is in them, you said by the Holy Spirit, through the mouth of our father David, your servant, why did the Gentiles rage and the peoples entertain folly? The kings of the earth took their stand, and the princes gathered together against the Lord and against his anointed. Indeed, they gathered in this city against your holy servant Jesus, whom you anointed, Herod and Pontius Pilate, together with the Gentiles and the peoples of Israel, to do what your hand and your will had long ago planned to take place. And now, Lord, take note of their threats and enable your servants to speak your word with all boldness, as you stretch forth your hand to heal, and signs and wonders are done through the name of your holy servant Jesus. As they prayed, the place where they were gathered shook, and they were all filled with the Holy Spirit and continued to speak the word of God with boldness. The word of the Lord. Blessed are all who take refuge in the Lord. Why do the nations rage and the peoples utter folly? The kings of the earth rise up and the princes conspire together against the Lord and against his anointed. Let us break their fetters and cast their bonds from us. Blessed are all who take refuge in the Lord. He who is throned in heaven laughs. The Lord derides them. Then in anger he speaks to them. He terrifies them in his wrath. I myself have set up my king on Zion, my holy mountain. I will proclaim the decree of the Lord. Blessed are all who take refuge in the Lord. The Lord said to me, You are my son. This day I have begotten you. Ask of me, and I will give you the nations for an inheritance, and the ends of the earth for your possession. You shall rule them with an iron rod. You shall shatter them like an earthen dish. Blessed are all who take refuge in the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia. If then you were raised with Christ, seek what is above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Alleluia, alleluia. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel. According to John, there was a Pharisee named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews. He came to Jesus at night and said to him, Rabbi, we know that you are a teacher who has come from God, for no one can do these signs that you are doing unless God is with him. Jesus answered and said to him, Amen, amen, I say to you, unless one is born from above, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Nicodemus said to him, How can a man once grown old be born again? Surely he cannot re-enter his mother's womb and be born again, can he? Jesus answered, Amen, amen, I say to you, unless one is born of water and spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. What is born of flesh is flesh, and what is born of spirit is spirit. Do not be amazed what I told you. You must be born from above. The wind blows where it wills, and you can hear the sound it makes, but you do not know where it comes from or where it goes. So it is with everyone who is born of the Spirit. The Gospel of the Lord. Well, we know that the Holy Spirit guides and protects us, and we're called, of course, to move with the promptings of the Holy Spirit. In our first reading today from the Acts of the Apostles, Peter and John have just been released from the Sanhedrin because they've been punished for their preaching God's word. And they come and tell the people what happens and say a prayer. And then they are emboldened by the Holy Spirit to give witness to God. And it's that they were filled with the Holy Spirit, and they continue to speak the word of God with boldness. And so this tells us today that we too, of course, are filled with the Holy Spirit from our baptism, and more fully from confirmation. And we're called, of course, to defend our faith and to proclaim our faith with courage and boldness, and then also to be witnesses to our faith in the workplace and at home and with our neighbors and family and friends. So it's important to let the Spirit guide us, because in order for us to know Jesus, we must have been touched in our hearts by the Holy Spirit, who guides and protects us and informs us and gives us the right words to say, as they gave the apostles, Peter and John, great power that the Holy Spirit did, so that they could proclaim God's word with courage and with fidelity. In today's gospel, a Pharisee named Nicodemus comes to see Jesus at night, and that's significant because, you know, he's a ruler in the Sanhedrin and a Pharisee, and he's probably afraid that people might see him visiting with Jesus. So he comes at night so he won't be seen, because he's probably afraid of what other people will think. You know, that, oh, you're a Jewish man, a Pharisee, and why are you talking with Jesus? So it's important that we don't, become embarrassed or afraid to seek out Jesus and to, call upon him. And so Nicodemus wants to find out more from Jesus. His faith isn't very strong, Nicodemus. He's seen Jesus' miracles, and he's curious, but his faith isn't strong. And so Jesus tells him to take the next step and become stronger in faith. And he says to Nicodemus that unless one is born from above, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Nicodemus doesn't understand and thinks that, well, how can I climb back inside my mother's womb and get born again? Of course he doesn't understand. He's confused. So Jesus tells him, unless one is born of water and spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. So Jesus there, referring to, of course, baptism, where we receive, we're poured with water, and our, of course, our original sins removed at baptism, and we're filled with the Holy Spirit at baptism. And it's, and Jesus tells Nicodemus the way that you must be born from above. So, of course, that means that we're called to seek what is above, not to seek earthly things here below. That we're called to be rich in kindness, love, mercy, forgiveness, and to grow in holiness, and patience, and humility. Those are all things that we all need to grow in. So it's important to be deep in faith, and of course to trust in the Holy Spirit, to trust in God. And then Jesus talks about the wind. And in Hebrew, the word ruah means wind, and it also means spirit. So the wind blows as it may, and so the Holy Spirit goes where he wants to go. And so it's important to follow the promptings of the Holy Spirit, and of course to be emboldened in our faith, and to seek the Holy Spirit so that we can know Jesus more fully. And once we have the Holy Spirit with us, we can know Jesus and proclaim his word and with great confidence and courage. And especially during this Easter season, we should be happy because joyful, because Jesus is risen from the dead. He gives us new life, and he fulfilled his promises, and it gives us hope. And he's offering us, of course, his mercy and his love. And so it's important that we respond to that. So let us pray on this Easter Monday, the second week of Easter, that we always keep deep faith in Jesus, trust in him, and that we follow eagerly the promptings of the Holy Spirit. as the Blessed Virgin Mary taught us in her life. As we offer our prayers to our Heavenly Father, let us be mindful of the needs of the Church and of the whole world. For Pope Francis, may the Holy Spirit continue to guide him as he shepherds his flock, the Church. Let us pray to the Lord. For world leaders, may God grant them the courage and wisdom in protecting the dignity and sanctity of human life. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who do not yet believe in God, may the Lord stir in their hearts a desire to know Him. Let us pray to the Lord. For this faith community, may the Holy Spirit increase in us the fruits of love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, generosity, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Let us pray to the Lord. For the faithful departed, particularly those who have no one else to pray for them, may the Lord welcome them in the heavenly kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord. For Leslie Ferguson, for whom this Mass is offered, let us pray to the Lord. God our Father, maker of heaven and earth, we ask you to hear the prayers of your family gathered here today. We ask this in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exalted Church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. Through him, the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising, the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith, we proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks to God that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Roger, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into a light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire you with all my heart. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, I ask you to come spiritually into my heart and unite myself to you completely. Please do not let me ever be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those you were pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.